one. Ah, woe be gone. Send for Mudlin. It's time we went through the accounts.
Oh, must we, dear? The sun's out today.
Tell the sun to wait. Mudlin, bring the accounts.
What, again? Oh, she's got a bee in her bonnet about accounts. Which reminds me of the last time we went through the accounts. Only that time it was Beowswain and his men who had bees in their bonnets.
If you go down to Cloppa Castle, be prepared to stay a while. For bygone vendor has been always doing battle for the oil. The western band we need from Grand is laid the fire free. And every day at 3 o'clock they all sit down to tea. Living in harmony with the friendly enemy. Living in harmony. A Cloppa Castle. Living in harmony with a friendly enemy. Living in harmony. A Cloppa Castle. So follow me.
Stand shut! I said stand to attention!
But we are, sir. It's our clothes that are standing at ease.
What a rotten shower. Osmosis, pop along to stores and fetch some patches.
They've run out, sir. They only have eye patches and a cabbage patch.
It's time we had new uniforms, men. I'll make out a requisite right away.
50 groats for repairing the gates and 75 for a new portcullis. Oh, this is too extravagant. We must economize.
Good morning, Your Majesties. I've just had a wizard idea.
If it's more material you're after, QED, the answer is no.
Good morning, all. What a beautiful morning. Mama, I simply must have a new dress.
Your Majesties, your men and myself are attired in rags. It's not becoming, Your Majesties. We cannot possibly defend you in this castle without new uniforms.
That's it. That is it. Uniforms. I've always wanted to try my hand at dress design. In fact, that's what I want to be. A costume designer. Genius has struck. I must work straight away.
Well.
And I'm sure you'll do it very nicely, Idlebone. And you, Tizzy dear, can sew them. Meanwhile, I intend to keep bees. So I shall go and get some hives. Elbow, I want your men to cultivate every available inch of soil for vegetables. And you, Woby, think of something.
Yes, my dear.
Mr. Elbow, sir, we haven't enough spades.
Well, you'll just have to lean on each other, then. Ow! Ow! Ooh! Ow! To arms! To arms! I've just been bitten!
What by? What by?
An ant! It bit my toe!
An ant? Oh! Which one?
I don't know. All ants look alike to me. I've lost my boot. Have you seen it?
Oh dear. We're planting in everything, you see, sir. And it's just the right size for a potato.
And just the right size for my foot, you feather-headed farmer. Stitch, what's this? The castle seems to be turning into a blooming Noah's Ark.
Please, sir, I've put the pigs in the dungeon.
Good. Should be safe enough.
And the hens are in the armory. Our helmets make lovely nests.
Oh, no!
I say. What did the pigs say as the sun grew hotter?
I don't know. What did the pigs say?
Phew! I'm bacon. Well, I thought it was funny.
Hey, what's Prince Idlebone doing near the Queen's beehives? Your Highness, be careful.
Don't interrupt my train of thought, Elbow. Designing clothes is a serious business. I'm waiting for inspiration to strike.
but not there.
Help! Help! Get them away from me.
Doesn't look as if inspiration will strike today. Bees got there first.
And that makes 5,753 overdrawn, plus another 24 groats, and...
There's a crowd of people outside the castle gates, Woby. They seem to be waiting to enter.
Yes, my dear. It is but a modest idea of my own. Now, don't let it trouble you.
But what, Woby, is this idea?
Merely tourists, dear, that are conducted round the castle for a small fee.
What? Strangers tramping round my... Eh? For a small fee?
Yes, dear. Unfortunately, the visitors I've conducted round the castle so far have had no money, so they've paid me in kind.
In kind? In kind of what?
In kind of rubbish, my dear. Come in handy for throwing at the enemy, Mom.
That's true, Elbow. You're a great comfort. You see, every cloud has a silver lining, and my bees are producing honey.
Yes, we had honey for dinner. And tea.
And breakfast.
Be of good cheer, Elbow. Your uniforms are here.
Get the men changed right away.
I think they'll have to look very hard to find the silver lining on this cloud.
I positively refuse, and so do all the others, to put on these clothes. It's ridiculous. We'll be a laughing stock.
If I say you'll put these clothes on, you'll put them on, whether you want to or not. If any one of you doesn't, I shall personally slice him to ribbons. Well, hench!
Ribbons don't suit my hair, sire. Don't they look splendid? And what a fit, like a glove.
I could hardly breathe. Oh, that's better.
Oh, do be careful, Kippo. You're not supposed to bend down.
Yes, very nice, dear. But why pink?
It's the in colour, Mama, for this season.
Well, you can have my uniform, miss. Honest, I don't need it.
You asked for new uniforms, and you have new uniforms. So that is that.
There is a party of ladies waiting to see around the castle, sire. The old ladies' sewing circle. But they look a bit strange to me.
Strange or not, as long as they pay, that's what counts, all right. Oh, my poor feet.
Cool. I'll bet they don't look as strange as we do. Come on, men. Sentry duty.
I have a funny feeling in my bones.
That reminds me. Why wouldn't the skeleton go to the dance?
I don't know. Why wouldn't the skeleton go to the dance?
Because he had no body to go with. Get it? Get it?
And here, ladies, we have the battlements with the finest view of...
Oh, pretty.
Pink soldiers! What is it killing me? Pink soldiers! Oh, this is killing me! I can't stop laughing!
Pink soldiers!
That's no lady!
But your wife?
No, it's Beowswain!
Oh dear.
Two arms! Two arms! 2 feet! Anything!
Bees!
Oh! Ouch! Oh! Ramming out!
Help!
Run!
Oh!
So he can't see in his bonnets.
Yes. They all have bees in their bonnets.
I say. Why does a tall man eat less than a short man?
I don't know why.
Because he makes a little go a long way. I say, Mama. The men aren't wearing my uniforms.
No, dear.
Didn't you like them then?
Frankly, no.
That's the trouble these days. Men of genius are never appreciated.
If you go down to Cloppa Castle, we prepare to stay a while. The bygones and the husbands always doing battles for the oil. A jolly bunch of chefs, they are the friendly
days, we managed to dispose of Beowswain and his men. Oh, but this economy drive has been totally disastrous.
May I make a suggestion, Your Majesty?
Oh, please do, Albright.
Supposing you sell some of your honey.
Why, Albright? Ruby, I've just had a marvellous idea. Why don't we sell some of my honey for money?
Why, Ethel Buddha, you think of everything.